H2K Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys supports 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus. One-time pay, lifetime access to live classes and videos. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For free demo class, visit h2kinfosys.com.
Okay, fine. As I discussed last week, we were discussing about the collection API. We have seen a list, right? We have seen, I told you there are three data structures in Java, but when you compare with C++, C++ has a lot of data structures. But in Java, there are only three data structures they have defined for us. Only three. What are those? List. List is useful to store duplicate objects. Objects means nothing but how do you create objects? You create objects using a class. Class name, object is equal to new class name. That's how you create object. What is the use of creating an object? To access non-static methods, non-static variables available in the class. This is the same thing I'm explaining from the day one. We have two types of methods and variables, static methods, non-static variables and non-static methods. How do you access non-static variables and non-static methods? Using object. So how do you create an object? So class name, object name is equal to new class name. So that's how you create an object. So list is useful to store duplicate objects. Duplicate objects. So what I have done, list is an interface. We have seen what is an interface. Interface contains abstract methods. Interface contains abstract methods. So what is use of interface? This interface is going to be implemented by some classes, and these classes are going to implement the methods available in the interface. So if you see list is useful to store duplicate objects. List is represented in Java as interface, and interface contains abstract methods, and these methods are going to be implemented by the linked list, array list, vector. So these three things we covered last week. So when you go for Selenium also, we have to know how to retrieve elements from the list. Okay, so this we have seen. Anyway, I'll show the program. Last week what you have seen the program, I'll show for an understanding. Let the Eclipse open. Okay, today we are going to cover set. Set is useful to store unique objects. What does it mean by unique objects? Means it will not allow duplicate objects. Even if you try to add duplicate objects, it will not allow. It will just ignore those objects. So we are going to see set today. Okay. Once we cover set, we have sufficient time to see polymorphism, which is an important concept, which I didn't mention in the day wise schedule, but I'll cover polymorphism, which is very important. That also I'll cover today. Okay. So let's let the Eclipse open. And the Eclipse is still opening. Let it open. So in summary, list is an interface which will store duplicate objects. So the classes implementing list are linked list, array list, vector. Okay. Set is an interface which will store unique objects which will be implemented by the classes hashSet, treeSet, linked hashSet, or the classes implementing set interface. Now we are going to see an example for hashSet, because hashSet is a class which is implementing the set. See, that's what I have written. hashSet, treeSet, linked hashSet are the classes implementing the set interface. Okay, sure, I'll do it, sure. Let that Eclipse open. So I'm going to show an example for the what we have seen in the last week, that is for linked list. Let's see first, then we'll go for hashSet. Okay, fine, let's see. Let it open. Why I am showing the linked list last week class is because the same way we are using to create a hashSet, the way how we created linked list. So if you see the linked list class as an example, hashSet is also so easy. That's what I am showing. So both are same. Only thing is the way it is implementing is different, because linked list allows duplicate objects, set allows unique objects. That's what I'm saying. Both are same. The way how you write them is same, but internally it is done differently, implemented internally. It will store duplicate, it will store unique there. That's what you see. Let's see now. what you have seen last week, we'll see. Suppose, for example, what I have told you, same thing I'll explain you, whatever you see last week, see here. Linked list. Linked list is a class. See here. I'm about to explain set, but I'm going to show linked list because for recollection for the law, like, you know, for the last week class, because we had the break, right? That's why I'm explaining linked list for small, for 2 minutes of time. I'll explain linked list, then I'll go to set. Okay. So what I have mentioned here, linked list is a class. See, linked list, list is equal to new linked list. Okay. Linked list, list is equal to new linked list. So here, list is an object. Here, list is an object because linked list is a class. We are creating an object of the class called list. See, new linked list. So let me unmute one person and see, like, you know, whether still they're hearing. My voice is breaking still. Let me talk to someone. Bala, are you still hearing me? Still hearing my voice is breaking? Hello? Okay, now good. Okay, cool. Fine. If you're still facing issues,
let me know. Sometimes it's good, sometimes it's...
Yeah, I understand. I don't know what's the problem behind it. I'm trying to figure it out. Okay, let's see. Fine, let's see. We'll proceed further, okay? Let's see. Yeah. Okay, sometimes it breaks. Fine, I understand, Shipra. I understand. Let's proceed, okay? Because... sometimes the network is an issue. I cannot try to resolve it. I try to resolve it. I call them, but still. Okay. If possible, mute all others. I muted everyone. Nobody unmuted. Okay. I muted everyone. If anybody has an issue, they type in chat window. I'll just unmute them. Okay. You don't have to worry for that. Fine. So linked list is a class. We are trying to create an instance of the class. List is an object of the class. Linked list, list is equal to new linked list. Okay. And we have to mention what kind of objects we are storing. We have to mention what kind of objects we are storing when you try to create an instance of the class. In specifically data structures, we have to mention what kind of objects we are storing. Here, we are storing an object called integer. So, integer, this is a class. Integer is a class. For data types, they have specifically mentioned classes. Int is a data type. Integer is a class. Oh, okay. So, for every data type, they defined a class which will help us to create an object for that data types. That's what I mentioned here. If you see here, int. Are you able to see notepad? Int. Int. Integer is a class. Float, capital F, a float is a class. So what happened here? For our understanding only, for our need, they created, for every data type, they created one class, because classes helps us to create objects. Okay, classes helps us to create objects. Let's go back to Eclipse. So in short, what I am trying to tell you is, linked list is useful to create duplicate objects. So if you see, I added 5, added 4 again, okay, and I'll try to print the list. When I try to print the list, these elements will be stored in the array. How it will be stored? 5, 4, 1, 4, let's display, and size gives the 4, and index starts from 0, that's why I told you 0, 5, 1, 4, 2, 1, 3, 4. When I say get of 1, I'll get 4. When I say get of 2, I get 1, okay, and I am trying to print these values using for loop, and I am telling again, list is index based means what? We can use a get function which is available in the linked list class, list dot get of index. Okay, list is index based. Again, I'm repeating, list is index based. That's the reason you are going to retrieve the elements using indexing, means list dot get of index. Here, list dot get of 1 retrieves 4, list dot get of 2, 1. Okay, that's the reason last time when I explained, people asked me two examples. I sent two examples, one for string, one for integers. For you people, for your understanding only, I sent two examples. If you recollect or not, I sent two examples for everyone. Okay, to check that, right? So how to retrieve the elements? You can retrieve the elements using for loop, right? See how we write it? For int I is equal to 0, I less than list dot size. What is size? Size is a method available in the linked list class. What is get? Get is a method available in the linked list class. So these are the methods available in the linked list class, which are non-static, and they are going to be called using, invoked using the object. What is object here? List is an object. Okay, the for loop, for int I is equal to 0, I less than list dot size I plus plus, and I am printing list dot get of I. Again, I am saying list is index based. That's the reason we are going to invoke using indexing, and there is a method for invoking the elements using indexing, which is called get method. Get method is available only in the list, not in the set. Okay, again, I'll write it here. I'm writing the notepad what I have told you. List is index based. List is an, or else for understanding, I'll write linked list. Linked list is an index based. So we can retrieve elements using get method, get of index. That's what we use, using index. These were list. Now we need to use write a same manner we'll write for hash set. Let's see the example. Yes, all the classes which are implementing list or index based, because get is a method which is an abstract, is defined in the list. So all these classes are index based. Okay, again, I'll write down here. Somebody is asking, so all are index based, because see, if I say one class, because every class contains these methods, so all are index based. Okay, fine. If you want to practice, you can change in the place of linked list, just replace with array list and just try the example. It will work. There is no change in the implementation. Okay, implementation is exact. There is no change. Okay. Now we'll see set. Okay, set. Let me write a program for set. We are going to set. So when I try to talk about set, set is an interface which will allow unique objects. The classes which are implementing set are hash set, reset, linked hash set. Okay, so what I'm doing right now is I'm creating an example for hash set. Let's create an example for hash set. Okay, let's see the Eclipse now. I'll close everything. I'll create a fresh one. Utilize a package. I think so. I created utilize a package. Okay, so let me create. Okay, I'll delete it. I already have something. Let me delete. I'll write a fresh one now. Let me write down the fresh one. New, right click new, class, what is the example? I'll keep it hash set integer example, hash set integer example. Okay, some name, the name is, this name I am keeping it my understanding, any name I can keep it. Okay, so I created some class name has set integer example. So let's start writing the program. So this program I want to execute. If you want to execute the program, you should write a main method. See, I'm writing a main method. See, main control space. Okay, you are writing a space. Fine. So what we are planning to do? We are planning to use the class called has set. So when I try to talk about a class, I have to create an object first. First, let me create a class. First, let me write to create an object first. Hasset, H-A-S-H, capital S-E-T, hasset. Then suppose for example, I just mention for understanding set is equal to new H-A-S-H-S-E-T. As everybody knows, whenever you try to write a class, use a class, we have to import it. How do we import it? Control plus Shift plus O. The class name, you can give any name, that's for our understanding. Okay, this class name is for our understanding. There is no relationship with this one and this one. This is available in the package. Let's see, Control Shift plus O. I'm just printing Control Shift plus O. Let's see, Control Shift plus O. See, this class available in this package. Java.util is a package. Okay, this is my understanding, my class. I'm creating my class. That name is different. This name is different. Don't confuse. Don't get confused. This class is available in the package java.util. Okay, so when compared with the last example, I told you what. So we have to mention what kind of objects we are storing. No, it's not class name object. That is different. This is the class available in the package java.util. We are trying to use the class available within that package, not this class, not this one. Okay. So hasSet is a class. We are trying to create an instance of the class. Okay. And as I told you in the beginning, we have to mention what kind of object we are storing. So let's try to store integers now. I'll mention integers. See, integer I am trying to store, INTEGER. Okay. Can anybody tell me, when I'm trying to use the class called integer, it is not asking me to import any statements. Why? Anybody knows why? Because when I say hasSet, it is asking me to import. But when I use integer class, it is not asking me to import. Can anybody knows why we are not importing this class? Because this class is also available in some package. Yes, somebody written it is in lang package. By default, java.lang is imported. We no need to import. Actually, this class is available. Are you able to see? This class is available in the package java.lang. Okay, the classes which are available in the java.lang are default getting imported. You no need to import. So, the classes which are available in java.lang, shall I tell you all the classes available in java.lang? System class, integer class. I think I already sent a mail. Somebody asked me about java.lang class. I think I sent a mail with all these details actually. If you want, just go and check it. Okay. Or else you